Give us jobs, jobs, jobs! Or a change of fortune, jump to go that boat, jump on jump, jump to give us jobs, jobs, jobs! Or a change of fortune, jump to go that boat, jump on jump, jump to go that boat, jump on jump, jump to go that boat, jump on jump, jump to get!
Hello, this is Ken Livingston. On Sunday, June the 10th, I'm going to be on the South Bank for the GLC's Jobs for Change Festival. It's a day of all sorts of music, videos, theatre and exhibitions for kids and grown-ups to celebrate what the GLC has done for jobs in London.
Give us jobs, jobs, jobs!
Today's service was a cherished ambition of the GLC's chairman, Iltyd Harrington, to prove that the strength of religion lies in being strong enough to overcome religious differences and worship together. As he sees it, religious discrimination and racial discrimination are much the same thing, and religious leaders were keen to set that example, whatever their differences.
London cyclists began to question why this should be and argue for fairer treatment on the roads. In 1981, the lobbying paid off. A new GLC administration was elected on a programme of reforming the whole of London's transport. Bus and tube fares were reduced, services improved, and a long look taken at the way our road space was divided.
Hello, I'm Dick Jones from the GLC cycling project team. I'm here at Paddington Station, which is at the start of the Ambassador Route, which is one of the first cycle routes which we designed and built in London. It shows a lot of the features that we've since incorporated into other schemes and a lot of the features that we've already seen in this film so far. So I'm now riding down through Hyde Park to Chelsea Bridge.
Peter Kinnard's striking montages are already well known to nuclear disarmers and have frequently appeared in peace movement literature. Today, 30 of them, under the collective title Dispatches from an Unofficial War Artist, went on show in the lobby of County Hall, alongside the petition against the sighting of cruise missiles in Britain, which nowadays greets all visitors to GLC headquarters. This, of course, is peace year, at least so says the council's ruling Labour group. Not so GLC Tories. They stayed away from today's ceremony while accusing Labour of callously exploiting the genuine fear of Londoners for political ends. The photo exhibition runs until February the 4th, but still to come in peace year, GLC-backed open-air concerts and films, a touring cabaret and a peace song contest.
Many a GLC member would like to see the Metropolitan Police Force accountable to County Hall and consider their police committee as a step towards that end. Mr. Reynolds is known to prefer private persuasion to public outcry, but he'll have to walk a tightrope between the Home Office-controlled status quo and the community-controlled police force called for by a growing number of pressure groups. Tower Hamlets has a community alliance for police accountability. It's become the prototype for a chain of monitoring groups across London. 12,000 GLC pounds provides and equips an office and pays a worker who coordinates 30 volunteers offering basic legal advice and general help to people in custody.
They're only talking about getting rid of the GLC because for the first time in living memory, the GLC's done something that's popular. We brought fares down, we've started improving public transport, and that's what the Tory government's terrified of. We are proving that you can have radical socialist policies and they work. That's why they want to destroy us.